I feel great. I feel a lot better than I did when I first came in, and I'm feeling just a lot better than I did when I first started.
What was it like when you first started?
I do remember actually the hit that I gave before I went down, and I ran another play after, and I just stood up after the first the initial play that hurt me, and the guy ahead from me helped me out, and he didn't touch me, and I just came to my coach and put my hand on my head and told him that, I can't do this anymore. I don't know what's wrong. Something's wrong. I was dizzy. I was disoriented. I didn't know where I was at. I didn't know what I was doing. It was scary time. I threw up a lot. It was scary, very scary. When I got here, they took out piece of my bone in my head, and they put it, like I said, they put it in the negative 80 degree freezer, and they sewed my head back up, as you can see but up here, and they took me apart. I've been a little swollen, as you can see. It's gotten a lot better. It used to be just bulging, just bulging. Yeah, I remember hitting the quarterback. I remember going down. I remember telling my friend Sam Bolin, I said, "I think I have a concussion, dude. I think there's something wrong with me." He said, stay on," because, it was an important game, and they were about to run another play, so I stayed on that another play, but I knew there was something going on. I was stumbling around. I could hardly walk, so after that second play, I decided to go to the sideline and not tell my coach about it, and he told me to sit down, and then I it's blank from there. Actually, it's blank from there, and I threw up, I guess, and yeah, it's really tough.
What did you tell your coach? Do you remember the exact words?
I said, "I, coach, I think I said I'm effed up. I think that I effed up. I messed up my head, and I think that I have a concussion." He said, "Are you sure? You and me, Marcus is our trainer at our Papillion La Vista High School, and he got hit Marcus, and Marcus came over and asked me a few questions and told me, I don't really remember that really that much, but I just remember Marcus coming over and talking to me for a little bit."
Getting onto that ambulance?
No, I don't. I don't remember getting onto the ambulance. I guess I was puking a lot on the ambulance. I honestly, I remember getting hit, going to the sideline, sitting on the bench, talking to Marcus a little bit, and then after that's pretty much a blur. It's blank. Well, I mean, obviously it was my right side, but I don't know. I think I just tackled with my head down and just right on my head. Just he was coming at me, I was coming at him, full force, 100%, and it just jarred me pretty good. I got a good hit on him, but in the end, it was pretty bad for me.
How did you know these concussion-like symptoms?
I was really dizzy. I was disoriented. I didn't know where I was. I seriously, like, I was on the football field and I was wondering, like, what am I doing? What am I doing? I really did not know what to think. I was puking, and I knew that something was going on. Whether it was a concussion or not, I knew something was going on.
Had you been taught what these symptoms are?
Yeah, I knew that you get real dizzy, you get disoriented, you puke a lot, things like that, things that happened to me. And so like I said to my son Sam, I said, "I think I have a concussion, man. I think there's something wrong with me. I'm feeling a little, woozy. I'm feeling, very nauseous and dizzy." And
Can you talk about the community support and seeing your teammates running through the field with your
it
jersey?
made me cry. It made me cry every single time I saw it. I watched so many videos. I read so many posts. It touched my heart. It really did. I couldn't believe it. I really couldn't believe it. I cried every single time I saw a video. I saw my friend Jack Schaefer and my friend Noah Phillips holding up my jersey, and it really touched my heart. It really did.